Welcome to Hot Springs. Today, I'm in Hot Springs National Park. Now, if someone was to ask you, what is the first national park in the US? The official answer would be Yellowstone National Park. President Grant gave his stamp of approval to Yellowstone in 1872. But 40 years earlier, this was the first federally reserved land, which leads many people to say, this is the first national park. Europeans have been coming to Arkansas since 1542 to visit the hot springs. 1542. The majority of the money flowing into the town, according to the hot springs, was definitely between 1911 and 1932. That's when Bathhouse Row was built, and it's kind of obvious as you drive through that that's when the majority of the money was spent on building the town. It's easy to say that Hot Springs National Park is extremely unique. It only has 26 miles of hiking trails, and it's the only national park to actually encompass a town. There are some other unique parts about the town that we're gonna check out today. The most iconic pictures of Hot Springs are of Bathhouse Row, and the National Park Service has actually started to take over those buildings that were built between 1911 and the 1930s. People come to Hot Springs for the health benefits. I imagine when Europeans discovered it in 1542, that they were pretty surprised to see hot water bubbling out of the earth. There are dots on the map where you can go to fountains and actually drink the mineral water, which is where we're headed now. So there are hot springs and cold springs. You can see that people still come here just to drink the water, which is exactly what I'm going to do. It's pretty good. You can definitely taste the minerals. It tastes kind of like bottled mineral water, but without the plastic. I'm walking back on the promenade with my new water. Already feeling the energy. Hot Springs is not getting any help from the weather today. Especially on this promenade, it just gives you like an eerie feeling that you're in another era. All of these are springs that are capped off for preservation, really to avoid polluting them. All of the springs are numbered, and because of the mineral content in the water, some of them have actually closed up. Interesting to see them as you walk through town and here on the promenade. This bathhouse is actually the visitor center for the national park. On a normal year, you would be able to run through it and see all the old like bathhouse setup and what it was like in the 1920s. Unfortunately, we can't do that today, but it is really cool to see them from the outside. This is the hotel where Al Capone would stay when he was in the area, apparently on the fourth floor, so he could keep an eye on one of his speakeasies, which I expect was one of these buildings. It's always a good sign of no corruption when Al Capone wants to be here. Souvenirs. Time for the hot water. I think it's gonna be really hot. How cool! It's perfect temperature. It's not cold out, but as soon as I drank it, it felt cooler out. Like all of a sudden the chill in the air is there. It is the perfect temperature. If I was gonna make tea or something, I would use this water exactly. Since it's warm, you can't taste the minerals as much. I'm gonna leave it in my water bottle and see if it tastes more minerally as it cools, but that is really enjoyable. I like that a lot. I can see why people would come here and think it's healing. That is awesome. Thank you for coming along with me today at Hot Springs National Park. Unfortunately, this is my last stop in Arkansas before heading home. This is my 8th national park. Oh, so much fun. You're gonna have to subscribe to see where I end up next. I'm gonna top up my water bottles and head out of town. I have to admit that this had hotel sink water in it this morning. So I did rinse it out a little at the fountain. Pretty good. It's just bricks. It's easy to say that Hot Springs is a unique national. It's definitely obvious in the architecture. Okay, don't hike in sandals. Oh. I mean, obviously I had to touch it. Leaving my grand terrace.
Be sure to hit that subscribe button. It'll help me bring you along on my next adventure.